SpaceX is getting closer to propel the first Starship to orbit this year. The company has been preparing the Starship SN24 and Super Heavy Booster 7 prototypes to perform the first ever orbital flight attempt. Join us as we bring you, Elon Musk just reacted on Starship Booster 7 engine firing, and what next for Booster 7. On September 19, SpaceX continued testing of its Super Heavy Booster 7 stainless steel vehicle. Its engines were fueled with cryogenic liquid methane and liquid oxygen. Only 7 Raptor V2 engines out of 33 were ignited on Monday afternoon. However, this is a great milestone because it is the first time ever they ignite 7 engines simultaneously. During Booster 7's previous static fire test on August 31, only 3 engines were ignited. Chamber pressure looked good on all 7 engines, shared Musk via Twitter soon after the test. When asked about when SpaceX will perform a static fire test of all 33 Raptor V2 engines simultaneously, Musk said the rocket will now undergo more preparations at the Starbase factory. Booster 7 now returns to High Bay for robustness upgrades and Booster 8 moves to pad for testing, said Musk. Next big test is probably full stack wet dress rehearsal, then 33 engine firing in a few weeks. Few days ago, SpaceX workers replaced one of the center engines, specifically engine number 7, from Booster 7. This raised some eyebrows, as the engine was not tested during the test campaign of the booster, and wasn't involved in the previous static fire tests. Work on these issues would follow over the next week until September 8. That day, both booster and ship were tested again, this time with a 33-engine spin prime test of Booster 7, and a 6-engine static fire test of Ship 24 that lasted about 6 seconds. Booster 7's 33-engine spin prime test was a long-awaited test. A prior attempt on July 11 resulted in a fuel-air mixture detonation, a few seconds into the test, that prompted several repairs and a redesign of the engine chilldown procedures. The new engine chill system sees the methane used for chilldown of the Raptor engines, going into a new pipe system, that collects and dumps it into a pit some distance away from the orbital launch mount. While simple and not necessarily elegant, this system has so far proven to avoid the fuel-air mixture issue that occurred during the explosion of the 33-engine spin prime test. While it isn't confirmed if this system will be permanent through launch, it does seem to provide SpaceX with the safety needed to at least push through pre-launch testing to a certain degree. Another 33-engine spin prime test was completed on September 12, in what appeared to be a carbon copy of the September 8 test. It is not unexpected that SpaceX teams may perform several of these full-engine spin prime tests before proceeding with more complex testing, as it provides a wealth of data that may be useful on how to execute the next steps. 2. Full stack, the vehicles, the Starbase launch tower's robotic arms will lift Starship SN24 atop the Super Heavy Booster 7 to perform pre-flight testing. When stacked, the vehicle is 395 feet tall, the largest rocket ever manufactured. Perhaps coincidentally, it may seem like work is ongoing at the Starship orbital launch mount to upgrade the water deluge system. New flexible pipes have been added to the outside, and the root of this system connects to the iron water pipes that lead to the orbital launch mount from one of its legs. However, it's yet to be seen how this will upgraded orbital launch mount support future testing of Booster 7, as it is currently sitting on the orbital launch mount and moved to High Bay for robust upgrade on Booster 7. This next testing phase was partly cleared off by the 7-engine static fire test on September 19. While the complete objectives of this new phase of testing and its schedule are still unclear, it is understood that Booster 7 will keep progressing with increasingly complex static fire tests with more and more engines. Booster 7's gradual approach to static fire testing will allow the teams to fix issues as they test and fully mature procedures and software ahead of the long-awaited orbital flight of Starship. Should this gradual testing go without a hitch, it could culminate in one or perhaps even 2 33-engine static fire tests of Booster 7 on the orbital launch mount. Once this testing is completed and any issues found fixed, it'll be cleared to proceed into another phase of testing. Ship 24 will then be stacked on top of Booster 7 for combined tests. This could include launch countdown simulations, an eventual full-up countdown, and a 33-engine static fire test. SpaceX hopes to complete this by mid-next month and clear both vehicles for launch shortly after. However, as we've seen in the past few weeks, any issues encountered during this intense test campaign could well mean a slip to later into the year and, perhaps, into next year. Despite this, the company is preparing for an aggressive launch schedule ahead. Booster 8 is now being prepared for potential testing, as teams hope to launch the second orbital flight shortly after the first one, ideally within 30 days. In addition, the vehicle is receiving its chines and other systems ahead of cryogenic proof testing, not long from now. Over the next few days and weeks, workers will outfit the vehicle with the hardware needed to proceed into cryogenic proof testing. If SpaceX hopes to quickly launch Ship 25 and Booster 8 right after the first orbital flight, we would likely see Ship 25 heading to the launch site for testing in the not-too-distant future. But the construction frenzy doesn't end there either. Booster 9 continues stacking in the Mega Bay as well. While its liquid methane tank was completed a few weeks ago, stacking is now at the halfway point for its liquid oxygen tank. Its vehicle pair, Ship 26, may have a stranger future ahead. As previously reported, Ship 26 and Ship the 27th of May be undergoing a radical change in plans, omitting thermal protection system tiles and not installing aerodynamic flaps. So far, this seems to be holding true with parts of Ship 26, seen now bare of tiles and on standby at Starbase's ring yard for stacking. Ship 27 parts are also proceeding similarly to Ship 26 parts. In some cases, there seems to be a strange mix match of parts for these vehicles. The 230-foot-tall Super Heavy is set to become the world's most powerful launch vehicle ever developed. Equipped with 33 methane-fueled Raptor V2 engines, the rocket is capable of generating over 17 million pounds of thrust at full throttle. Such an immense amount of force is required to propel the 165-foot-tall Starship to orbit with around 100 tons of cargo. Megatons of cargo will be needed to build the first self-sustaining city on Mars. SpaceX founder Elon Musk hopes that a fleet of at least 1,000 reusable Starship Super Heavy launch vehicles can enable humanity to become a multi-planet species by 2050. The company plans to build the Starships within the next 20-year period. Musk runs around-the-clock operations at SpaceX to achieve this ambitious goal within the time frame. Their goal is to achieve launching a Starship to orbit before this year ends, and begin launching payload satellites in 2023 that will help speed up the spacecraft's development. Then, SpaceX will manufacture a lunar-optimized Starship human landing system to return astronauts to the lunar surface sometime in 2025. SpaceX is still pending a spaceflight license from the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration to launch the rocket ship to orbit. According to a regulatory filing, SpaceX plans to launch the full stack from Starbase, land the booster at Boca Chica Beach, in the ocean or attempt to catch it with the launch tower's arms. Thanks for watching this video and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this to make sure you can subscribe. If you have any crazy idea what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we will see if we can get the, and thanks again for watching and goodbye.